There we are. And see what it does in the X direction. It squeaks and beep, beep. Here I am with the dial again, and let's see, I want to jog now for 1/10 of a millimeter. That seems to be pretty good, but yeah, I think the next interesting thing is to engage the feedback here from my lunar scales here and get rid of that backlash, as you saw there. The holding torque of that motor isn't all that strong, and I can do this without any problems. But if I increase those parameters, it started to vibrate. Perhaps it is possible to do one more round on that, but I think linear scales is an interesting thing here. And actually I can use the old configuration for the stepper motor, because this one behaves just like a stepper motor. Just at a little worse timing. So I will make a copy of that config and work with it. Linux CNC started with a config for the old stepper motor configuration. Only one thing that has been modified, and that is the timing. But for the rest it should be fine. Linear scales are engaged. See if it works. It does. So just take a few small steps with 1/10 of a millimeter. Are we on the same page? We sure are. Yeah. I think it overshot a little bit. Corrected it pretty nicely. I think it overshoots, but it seems to be pretty okay. Speed test. Yeah, that works. More speed. No, I think it is. I limited the speed in some way here, but I think that worked fine. But as I said, I can see that it overshoots a bit there. You can see that there. It takes 1 millimeter. And this flips back a little bit. And that I can modify here, because this is in Linux CNC. That overshoots that. And then I need to bring up the hull scope and all that. I will do that tomorrow, guys. I have now connected up the servo and tuned it as good as I can. It's even now included in Linux CNC and use the linear scales here as feedback. So when I test it, I typically do 1 5 millimeter stroke, forward, backward, and then measure the following error for that. And here's how I do that. And of course I need to have a certain speed set here, and I have now chosen to use 300 millimeter per minute, and that is kind of an average milling speed, I suppose. I can go much faster and I can go much slower, anyways. And the response can look like that. So that is 10 micrometers per division here, so that is something like 50 micrometers in following error for the servo during that step. I have also the blue line, and that is the y-axis, so I can actually show both of them together here. That could be interesting. And we can see that they are actually rather comparable in magnitude. So the blue one, that is a stepper motor, so you can see that the position error is rather similar in magnitude. The servo has an additional error peak when it is stopping. So it's going from a certain speed and to stop, which the servo does not have. I have to say here also that the y-axis now, it has to carry also the weight of the saddle here, so maybe that one carries double the weight compared to the x-axis. But it's not bad, for that servo it's not bad, I think. Tuning of the servo in Linux NC is a matter of setting the PIND values. And I experimented back and forth. I have 50-50 and 5 micron, and for the y-axis, which is a pure stepper motor, is 30-10 and 5 micron. So it's not that far off, but I use a much more I-term. I cannot use the P-term very much higher than 50 here, then it starts to oscillate. I'll try to read up on this, and what I have here, that is a PIV controller, not a PID, it's a PIV, V for velocity. And it has three loops, and the one I have now done in Linux in C, that is the outermost loop here with the position feedback from the encoder readings into Linux in C to set a certain position. And internally here, that is in the servo controller. So have a look at the servo controller. So if we look at the innermost loop, then that is the current loop. And that is what I have here, and that is as I have shown that to you before. So that is that setting. It doesn't really have to do with motor as such. It is more internally in the controller. And I really question why I need to go in and tune that. Couldn't that be automatic? Yeah, okay. So that is a current loop. And what I've seen is that so this one is responsible for the squeaking noise. If there is too high settings here, it will start to squeak, and I have reduced those values to make sure that it doesn't squeak. I wasn't so fond of that. And the velocity loop, that is tuned by doing steps back and forth. And looking at the response here, and that is the purple response that is really interesting here. So it should be as low as possible, and I guess also as steady as possible. These values I have got by following the instructions in the manual, but also by varying them up and down and see if there is an effect, each one of them, until there is no more effect. So right now I don't see exactly how I could improve this, and I need to save it, of course. Please close the window. There we have the saving. Save for EEPROM. Okay, and here's a pretty neat thing here. So if I exit that one and go into the tuning software again, it's reading parameters. I have this up together with Gmokapi, so I have it here in the background. And it's a nice thing here. So have a look at the X coordinate here. So when I do a step here in the tuning software, yeah, it's alive and counting. And that is a very good feature, I think, that the linear scale always keeps track of the position. It doesn't matter if the motor is losing step, so it's performing bad in any way. The position is always kept under control with the linear scale, and I think that is a very good thing. Anyways, in order to do the tuning, I had to have the machine off here, otherwise it would not have allowed me to do that. But there's more to say about the motor. I felt that the holding power was pretty weak before, but with the tuning now, I cannot say it is weak. But the holding torque, that is one of the things that really differs between the servo motor and the stepper motor here. This one is 0.57 newton meters, and this one is 8 newton meters, so that is a factor 15 or something. So the stepper motor should really be much stronger. The other thing is, of course, the speed here. This one goes easily up to 3000 RPM, and this one doesn't. This one is around 1000, I would say. 1000 RPM, perhaps a bit more. I also read on the internet, so that is of course true now, but people actually use this. But then they gear down it, so there is a reduction of 3 to 1. So that means that the servo motor goes 3000 RPM, but the ball screw will only go 1000 RPM. That also increases the torque by a factor 3. So what you see here, this is not really a workable, or this is not a solution that is used, but with a geared reduction, it can be used. Another thing is the rated power, 180 volts, and this one is a bit over 400 volts, so also there is a factor of 2. But still, you saw in the position error plots I made first, it is comparable in fact, so it's not bad, not bad at all. But this with a geared setup here, and using a belt in between here, maybe I can check that.